Hi there, my name is Sandy, and this is my beautiful craft room. This room is new to me. I moved into this room in October when our son moved out, and it is a tiny room, but it's perfect for me and my needs. I make junk journals, so there are a lot of components that go into making junk journals, and I'm going to show it all to you. This is an IKEA Skarsta table, and this is where I work the majority of the time. I found it on OfferUp, and I think I paid about half of the normal cost, which I think is like $250. And then under here, I have all my trims organized by color, and I just used hair ties and magnetic hooks. So it doubles as a nice decoration, and also if I don't do this, I won't use them because out of sight, out of mind. So that's why they're there. And then moving to the left, this is my enormous filing cabinet. And on the side here, I have more trims. So I have one for white, black, and gray, and I have one for Christmas, and then my browns and tans and creams. So also, sorry about my hands. I had some sun damage burnt off by my doctor, so I'm waiting for them to heal. On the back of my door, I have a fabric shoe rack that is perfect because it has mesh fronts so I can see everything. This is my punch collection. I don't have a lot of punches. I just have the punches that I know I will use over and over. And then down here, I have a lot of extra adhesives. So I always like to have a backup because the worst thing is just running out. And so that's where all of these things live. I do have some distress stain and some brushes and sandpaper and just things like that that are a little bulky and would otherwise be harder to store. This is actually my son's high school graduation tassel. Again, this is his room, and it can become his room again anytime he needs it. So that will stay there. And then moving up here, these are some shelves that house some books that I will probably not be able to cut up because they're just beautiful. And they're in pretty good shape. Well, some of them are, but. And then on this shelf, I have supplies. These house all of my playing card decks. They're all organized in there. And then I have my vintage label maker that I found at an estate sale, and that's there to remind me to use it. Again, out of sight, out of mind. These are for my smaller Etsy packs. I sell ephemera packs on Etsy, and that's where those live. And then journal cards that I use in my personal journals and in the journals I make. And then down here on top of the filing cabinet, this is my shipping station. So I love to use this paper to wrap up my orders. And then I use baker's twine to finish them off. And then I love to add goodies in with my orders. So that's kind of what all this stuff is. And even washi samples, washi tape to, again, to wrap those orders, my scale. And this is my big shot. When I first started this hobby, I wasn't sure that I would use a die cut machine like this. They're big and bulky and expensive. And this one actually found me at an estate sale. It's electric, so it's even more expensive. And it was $25, so I had to get it. And I'm really glad I did. I don't use it a ton, but I do use it. And then for that, right below it, I have everything I need for it, which is my platforms, my cutting mats. I have some embossing folders, ones I use over and over, and then a few basic dies like circles and ovals and just kind of the basics. And then more about this filing cabinet. This cabinet is huge, and it was $10 at an estate sale. Yes, you heard me right, $10. And it came with all the folders and all the labels. So I was absolutely thrilled, and I have filled it up. So in this front part, I have kind of all the little miscellaneous stuff, stuff to sew, stuff to file, stuff to cut up, things like that. And then these are my larger paper scraps, which even within the files, I have kind of separated. I have in the fronts, I have all the double-sided paper. And then I have a cream cardstock piece. And then after that, I have all the single-sided paper. So because I make junk journals and I don't really like to have white backs on my pages, that's why I have them separated. So these I know I can use in my junk journals. And again, these are just the big scraps. I have the little scraps in another place because they have another use. So this is all journal scraps. So this is all kind of neutrals and things like that. And then I have kind of a sticker folder just for kind of miscellaneous stuff that I don't know what to do with. So that's that. And then back here I have all of my vintage wallpaper. I have lots of different colors. It is separated by colors for the most part. And I have even like borders. They're so beautiful. And I love this stuff. And then on this side, I have my Etsy orders. My bigger ephemera packs live here so that I can grab them quickly. And again, they're really close to my shipping station. So then I have extra envelopes, and I even have, I cut up all of our cereal boxes and food boxes so that I can add them to the envelopes to keep them nice and sturdy for shipping. Okay, and then moving on in the second drawer, this is where most of my paper is for my junk journals. So it's all alphabetical. So we have first start with my bags, and then I have book pages, kids' book pages. It is a little full right now, so it is a little annoying, but just means I need to make more journals. So I have botanicals, I have calendar pages, cookbook pages, more cookbook pages. Encyclopedia. I have this really cool kids dictionary, envelopes, and then I have forms. These are so cool. And then I have graph paper, and then I have craft paper, ledger paper, lined paper, and then we go into maps and magazines and music paper, kids music, paper dolls, placemats. I have a lot of stationery, which is really great. And then we go to textbook pages, tissue, and vellum down there. Wow, this is really hard. It's a lot of books. Okay, let's go to the third drawer down. And this one is kind of more miscellaneous. So this is where I keep all the cardboard, like all the, like the backs of paper pads and things like that. These make really great covers for my junk journals. And then these are vintage file separators. They also make really great covers. And then I have actual book covers that will be made into books someday. There are really great ones in here. And then this cool Cavallini folder will make a really great journal. More book covers. And then these folders are all themed folders. So I have Asian, Valentine's Day. Valentine's Day is a big one for me, so I have a lot of stuff. And then I have babies and spring and summer, beach, animals, farm. This one is fall. I need to re-glue this one. Fall. And then I have manila folders that I know I can just cut up. I have some more book pages that are kind of fragile and I can't really use as book pages in my journals. And then these folders are all of my vintage wrapping paper, which is just so beautiful. I love it all. I love it all. And then back here, this is all my Christmas stuff. So I had so much Christmas stuff that I had to separate it to keep myself organized. So I have wallpaper, stationery, miscellaneous mini pages, cookbooks, calendars, all that. And then that is my vintage Christmas wrapping paper. So that's where that lives. So that is the giant, wonderful filing cabinet. And then this is a Calyx unit. It's new. And it's one of the only things I bought full price in this room. In this bin up here, I actually don't know what's in there. It might not have anything in it, actually. Okay. These are the We Are Memory Keepers paper sorters. And these are kind of themed as well. I can't keep 12 by 12 paper in my filing cabinet, so the paper lives here. And it's also handy when I'm feeling lazy and I find something that works for a theme, I can just shove it in here. Like, I found this book page, which is perfect for a baking journal, and I just put it in here. And then moving on down, I have these acrylic drawers, and in this one, I have beads. I use beads for tassels and charms on my journals. And then this one is more metal things and kind of incoming, like when I get packages in the mail, I can just throw them in here. And it's also nice because it's a nice shallow drawer. I can see everything I have. So these are just kind of random journals, tassels that I've made. And then this drawer is for my paper scraps. So this is kind of my junk drawer for my paper scrap. When I make journals, I make a lot of paper scraps, and it all just, I just chuck it all in here. And then when this fills up, then I separate it and figure out where it goes. So it's nice to be able to just throw it in here, and but I'm able to stay organized at the same time. And then I have another one of these. So again, these are kind of themes. And then I have my washi tape drawers, which are not completely full of washi tape. I don't have that much washi, but I like that I can use this extra space in back here for, I love to use these when I'm journaling. So I can keep a whole bunch of different washies instead of having a bunch of rolls. So that's what, and they are kind of organized by color. And then these are my metallics and neutrals, but also I have like multicolored, and then I have kind of Christmas. And I have more samples back there. And then down here, this is all my 12 by 12 paper, not all of it actually, but it's all 12 by 12 paper, and it's organized in these cropper hopper page holders, or blah, paper holders, and I put them on their side so that I can pull the paper in and out. And it is organized by color, but also by whether it's double-sided or single-sided, so that's what the DS is. So double-sided yellow, and then over here I have single-sided red, green, and then theme. And then down here, this is on my cardstock. I don't use a lot of cardstock, so I may never use this, but it's here when I want it. It's pretty handy for die cutting, actually. And then next to my Calyx Zenit, in this little corner pocket here, I have my tape gun for my orders, and then I have, this is all my wrapping paper. So this room is extremely handy for wrapping presents, so that's why I keep it all in here. But I also have my vintage wallpaper that is still on rolls that lives here. I have some extra boxes for shipping, and then I have some newly acquired wallpaper border down there. And then I even have some vintage wrapping paper there. So that's that. And then moving on to this fabulous desk. I love this desk. This desk I found at an estate sale. It was $200 for all three pieces. Actually, it's way more pieces because it also includes the chair and this piece, which is a separate piece. It just sits on top of there. I love. And the top is in fabulous condition, which is great. The rest is kind of shabby, which I also love. So on top, I have my tool caddy, which is really handy because it's all right there. And I only keep kind of my most used things in here. So I have my masking tape. I have some actual tools, which come in handy for different things. And then I have all of my hole punches, so various sized hole punches. These are my X-Acto knives, my box cutter. And then this is kind of for wrapping paper, my score tape, adhesives, and then these are actual pens, my fussy cutting scissors, and this is a glue pen, bone folder, just my paintbrush. And then in the middle, I have my Tim Holtz ruler, which I use constantly. We Are Memory Keepers corner rounder, and then some scissors, and then I have a Zutter corner rounder here, which is also his really handy. Okay. And then in these drawers, which I really should label because it's kind of a pain, I have a rotary trimmer. So these are where I keep the extra blades. And some tags. I need to coffee dye. A paper distress tool. Another corner rounder. Can never have too many. And then this is another razor. It's handy for scraping and different things like that. Moving on, let's start in this drawer here. This is kind of a hodgepodge drawer. These are a little container that I keep all of my eyelets in. And I have, they're mostly little eyelets, which I don't use a lot, but I also have some miscellaneous things in there, but they're pretty organized by color and metal color. And then in this one under here, I have brads, which again are pretty organized, and it's nice that they have their own little sections. And then this is kind of my catch-all drawer. It's all those little pieces of paper that I can't throw away, but I don't know what to do with. And so they kind of go in here, and then as it fills up, then I kind of deal with it. I either recycle what I know I won't use and put away the things that I think I will. And then my staplers, I have, this is an old Fascinator that has those giant staples. I don't know if any of you are familiar with that. Don't use it a lot, but I can't seem to get rid of it. And then I do have a couple different staplers because I like to use different color staples in my journals. And then this is yet another hole punch and my tab punch. And then in here, I have some of these really cool napkins. And then I have more kind of tiny embellishments that I don't use a lot, but they're there if I need them. Okay, that is the top drawer. Moving down. Okay, so these are my paper punches. I use these myself, but I also like to give them away with my orders. So that's where I keep all of these, and they're semi-organized by color. And then, oh, under there I have all my tickets. Some are vintage, some are new. Love tickets. Then I have buttons and flowers. And back there, I have some pretty napkins. And then kind of some journal cards, which I know I'll never use. I should really get rid of. And then an extra container that is just hanging out, waiting to be used. So down here, this is where my scraps live. And there is a method to my madness. So I have little bitty scraps that I can't throw away. I don't know. I mean, I do use them. So it is, there's the reason. And then these are kind of my smaller, well, kind of medium scraps. They are separated by, these are cardstock, and then these are real regular paper. And these, this size is really great for using for punches. So that's what the majority of these are used for. And these have the double use of being for punches, but also for when I make journals, these can be tucks and pockets. So they're handy for that. And then going down further, these are strips. So these I really like to use to make journal cards. So these are the colored strips, and then I have neutral strips. And then down here I have more strips. These are bigger strips that again are good for using with punches. So, and again, I have them separated by cardstock and by regular paper under there. So that's that. And I just used the boxes and the lids, and it's pretty handy and darn cheap. So these are my fabric and trim scraps. Anything that's not big enough to keep over under my desk, they live here. So this one is neutrals, obviously. This one is red, orange, yellow, and pink. And then this one is green, blue, and purple. So that's where those live. And I can use these for a multitude of purposes. And then also, this is kind of like incoming. You know, when I get orders in, I can just kind of put it here until I'm ready to deal with it. And then this sweet paper came with the desk, and I couldn't bear to rip it up because A, it's clean, and it's so cool. So that's that. Next, I have this drawer, which is extremely handy because it holds my cutters. So I have my old Creative Memories cutter, which is so handy. And then I have one of these, which I rarely use, but I will never get rid of because it's very nice. And then I use this for cutting fabric on my mat. And again, for using cutting fabric, it's really nice. These are all of my sticky notes. And then I have my mixed media mat that lives right here. Measuring tape and a light. I'm ready to go. So that's in there. And then under here, I have some extra bins, some Christmas ephemera, and just extra products. And then there is my journal tote that I can take anywhere, and it has everything I need ready to go. Okay, moving on. I have my tissue and my little bits and bobs tray. I have some fabric, my Canon selfie printer, and then I got this at an estate sale. I think this one was $5, and in the top I have all of my stickers, and they are organized by color. So this is kind of pinks and reds, I think, and then yellows and oranges, and then greens, purple, and then neutrals. And then I move into stamps. So these are red stamps, orange stamps, blue and green. You get the gist. And then down here I have, these stamps are still on paper, which are really fun to use for collage and different things. And then I have some vintage glassine envelopes with stamps in them. And then I have some button cards in there. This one is full of different colored baker's twine, which I like to have keep handy. And then in these, I have some purchased, so these are new labels and some printable labels, kind of organized. And then down here is more printable labels that I've organized by color. So this is kind of the reds, blues, and then I have these really cool price tags. And then these are mini like pharmacy labels. And then, yeah, you get that, yeah, green and brown. That's all of that. And then these are just some cute books that I made that have, they use up some scrap paper. Those are fun. And I think I made them, I'm not sure what these cards are. I don't know if they came with a game or what, but they're so cool. And then this is where my sewing machine lives. It's all plugged in and ready to go. I just pull it over to the front of the desk here. And then in here, in this drawer, I have all of my sewing stuff, which is not a lot, but I keep this paper here to test out my stitches. Because, you know, when I switch from zigzag to straight, I like to know what I'm doing. And then under here, I kind of have threads and needles and my scissors. And then this is kind of odds and ends, like, you know, stuff that I don't know that I'll use, but I can't seem to get rid of at the same time. So that's what's in there. Under here, I have a trash can, and this basket kind of corrals all of my cords. So that's there. And moving around, this is the top of this cabinet where I have some journals that I made up there. And then some books that probably will become journals. And then these are some projects that I need to finish. And then more of these containers that I bought at estate sales. This one holds all of my paper clips. So I have different colors and I have different shapes. And I even, those are vintage, which are really cool. And then more. And these are also vintage and they're little. They're so little. They're so neat. And then I have even more. Lots of gold ones. Too much gold ones. And then I have my bold pins. And these are hinge clips that I use for my journals. For the tassels and things. These are the Fascinator staples. So they're really big staples. And they do have some different colors. I don't use a lot of silver when I make my journals. So. And then kind of get some bobs, book corner covers. This is just a cheap rack that I like to hold some cards to remind me to use them mostly. And some envelopes, some really neat envelopes. So just here for inspiration and a reminder, use me. Up here I have some elastic cord that is A, vintage, and B, coffee dyed, and then some more lace. And then this really neat little chest of drawers was $1. I love it so much. And it holds punches that are too big for that other container. So that's what these top drawers are. And then I have like my re-inkers and more. And more. These are more of those. And miscellaneous and rubber bands, which I use all the time, so those are handy. And then this is where I keep all of my bags for packaging my listings. Well, this is where I keep the small bags anyway. And then some labels. All right, moving on. I found this sweet recipe box at an estate sale, and it is full of handwritten cards, which I love. And then in this one, again, I found it at an estate sale. I have kind of my smaller ephemera bits And again, they are organized by color. So pink and red and yellow. You get the idea? And then this is for my vintage label maker. It's all the tapes. I have a lot of tapes. And then I have some milk caps, which I love. I love milk caps. Then I just have some miscellaneous like stamps and lip balm, which I can't leave without. Some clips for my bulletin board. And then these are just like printables, small printables that I need to put into the colored section over there. And some little bits and bobs. And these are some fussy cut items. They're just kind of random. I love to journal with those. And then these are plastic bobbins that I like to put washi tape samples on. Inside here, I have all of my sequins. I don't use a lot of sequins, but I like to have it for those times that I want it. And then I have a really cool calling card collection. So lots of different, really neat calling cards. Some are pretty grungy, but some are in fantastic shape, especially considering how old they are. And then over here, I have some neat like luggage stickers. So they're from different hotels and different things like that. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, so that's that drawer. Under here, this is where I keep all of my paper coasters that I like to use in my journals. And I have lots of different ones in here. Down here is the, somewhere down here, is the ones that originally came in this tin. Then I have lots of other ones too. I love them. Let's see, this is a journal I recently made. And then this has I'm starting to get into the wax seals. So that has stuff in there for that. And that is that bin. So moving down, this drawer, which is right behind my table, so it's extremely handy. I have my journal binding supplies, so my cord and my, I use lots of large paper clips and binder clips, and then my needles are in there, my awls are in there, all that stuff, and I keep this card for smushing glue. And then I have a bunch of templates that I can use over and over again. And then back here, I just have some random binder clips and some vintage push pins. And then I keep this bin is for when I want to make fabric paper clips. I can take this with me in the car. It just has fabric scraps and the paper clips, and it's ready to go. This one has all of my fiber, which again, I like to use this when I make tassels and things like that. So that's where that lives. And then here is kind of, again, random stuff like tabs and staple remover. This is all of my ink because my printer is right there. And just some miscellaneous stuff. And then these are fabric paper clips that are ready to go in journal. So they're kind of separated by color. So they're ready to go. Okay, there is that drawer. And then down here, I have, this is a bin of vintage napkins for different themes. I don't have a ton, so I'm able to keep them all in here. And then my iron, because my ironing board is in here. Back there is my Canon paper, or the paper for my Canon selfie. And then this is what I use to punch my holes when I'm binding. And then I just have some rags for cleaning up. This is a degreaser for cleaning up. And then in here, up here, I have, this is like Christmas fabric scraps that I can use for tassels or for paper clips, things like that. And then back there, I have another container that is full of Christmas ephemera, small Christmas ephemera, like gift tags and just things like that. These drawers house all of my personal journal stuff. So the stuff that I like to use in my own journals. So it is very random, like different printables, vintage ephemera, it's paper scraps, it's all kinds of stuff. And it doesn't need to be more organized than this because it's great. This is perfect. And then these are things that I like to, sometimes I will, if I'm going on a trip and I want to take a small amount of stuff, I will put it in this pouch And then this is more just of my own journal stuff. And then down here, oh, this is just ephemera from my life. So like letters and cards and just like menus, you know, current ephemera. Well, except for that. Except for that wallpaper scrap in there. And then that is where my big bite lives. So that's handy. And that is this cabinet. Moving on. So this cabinet was in my son's room and he didn't want it when he moved out. So I painted it and it's actually pretty great because it's so deep that it holds a ton of stuff. So this is where my printer lives. And then this rack is kind of miscellaneous stuff. I keep some paper for printing. And then these are some sticker books that I don't have a lot of sticker books, but that's where they live. And then this is where my 6x6 paper pads live. I have a couple of 8x8 paper pads. My envelope punch board is here. And then I have one of my Christmas journals and a couple of journals that I made, and then just some different organizing things. That's where that lives. And then these craft boxes organize most of my ephemera that I like to use in my journals and my own personal journaling. So that's what those are. And then these bins hold all of my fabric scraps and they're kind of organized by color. And then this is, this box, I made all of these boxes with cardstock, and these have ephemera that is organized by color. So if I want to add ephemera to a journal, and all I have to do is come in here and I can select things by color, which is great. It's heavy. Okay. And then again, more ephemera. This is larger pieces of fabric. So these are not scraps. I mean, they're scraps, but they're big scraps. So they're folded. And then down here, I have another box within this box of trims. So lots of rickrack and lace and lots. And they're pretty much doubles of the ones that I already have under my desk. And then these are greeting cards. This whole thing is greeting cards. And then this one is all of my stamps, my stamp blocks, my embossing powder, my heat tool, my stencils. They all live in here. And I even have a little bit of glitter in there. So that's where all of that lives. I don't do a lot of stamping or embossing, so that's why I'm able to keep them all in this bin. More ephemera, and then more ephemera. So that's that. And then I have my two trash bins here. In this bin, this is kind of a hodgepodge bin. I have yarn and bells and vintage trim. And then more baker's twine. So this is pretty unorganized, but it really doesn't need to be more organized than this because I can pretty much see what I have. I have some lace, large lace. So that's what's in there. And then I have, this is kind of where I keep my large vintage ledger pads. Again, it's really nice how deep this bookcase is because I can keep those all in there. And then this is some 8.5 by 11 cardstock, more paper for printing, and then I have some paper pads in here, and I have some scrapbooking paper that I bought multiples of, so that's where all of this lives. It's and then more paper pads, and then these are these kits that you get at, like, crosswords. That's where these live. I do eventually break them up, except for the ones that are themed like this. I won't break that one up. So that's that. And I think that is it. We've done it all. Up here I just keep a bulletin board with some random cool images. And then there is my ironing board. And that's it. Thank you guys all for watching. If you have any questions, leave me comments below and I will gladly tell you anything you need to know. Thank you so much. Bye.